Hi, I'm the independently elected state treasurer, Rob McCord, and I'm running for the Democratic nomination on May 20th. I want to be the Democratic nominee who defeats and evicts Tom Corbett. The courts have told Tom Corbett what I think most of the public already knows, and that's that the local impact fee is bad law. I think it ought to be replaced with the driller's tax. Some call it an extraction tax. I travel the state so much, I realize sometimes people get a glassy look, and it's like, you don't know what we're talking about when we say this, right? So it's a driller's tax, and it would be imposed on those who are drilling a natural resource that cannot be drilled from outside of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, a core point here when you're talking about job creation. We would hold harmless, by the way, the local communities that have enjoyed revenues for real impacts, real costs on these local communities and counties and infrastructure projects and so forth. But we'd have dramatically increased revenue from $200 million to $1.63 billion under the McCord proposal for a driller's tax, a 10% fee. And the lion's share of that would be earmarked for investing in education, education, education. But we'd also have enhanced revenue for environmental protection. The fact is there is a debate in the Democratic Party. There are people nicknamed for activists who say stop it now, ban it now. I am with the caucus of people who say that there is a moderate, innovative, reasonable way to pursue this. But we have to engage in appropriate environmental protection, and we have to measure and engage in the quest for evidence. So what does that mean? That means, first of all, we need to understand when we're explaining to people sort of to my left on the issue that we're hoping to get people to substitute away from worse sources of energy. So when you're talking about global climate change and the very compelling recent report about the ongoing tragedy there, to say, look, we're getting people to substitute away from coal makes sense. But guess what else we need to do? We need to address fugitive gas emissions. We need to be thinking about alternative fuel vehicles, but public-private investment in research that would drive down the methane emissions. I do not. I recognize the real fragility of these environmental situations, and I think that there's more than enough land available for fracking. We would embrace innovative approaches to worker training programs the first 2 years out of high school, for example. They don't have to always be four-year degrees. And we would invest again in both state-related schools, Pitt, Penn State, Temple, Lincoln, and state schools. You know, first of all, I would enforce the laws and regulations. In some of these cases, it sounds like these companies knowingly violated prohibitions in their contracts. So they can say, oh, look at the contract. It's right here. It's like, yes, but the law said you couldn't put that into the contract. Also, obviously, by having a generalized driller's tax, communities in general profit. It's not just sort of the one at a time. You know, you're lucky you got hit by the laser of profit. And you, on the other hand, have all the hassle of all the traffic and no real gain in your community. I'm deeply concerned, and I think we've had an appropriate debate, but the debate has now been addressed. The people who like to create clouds of doubt are fully funded by those who have a for-profit interest in creating the doubt. The thing that it saddens me is, whereas I'm certain I can build a consensus to get a driller's tax, and I'm certain that I can earmark some of the increase in revenue and environmental protection, and yes, in innovation and technology development that will help somewhat to remediate the emissions that can lead to global climate change. I am far from certain that Pennsylvania or the United States of America as a whole will finish fully doing the right thing. And I think I do think this is one of the saddest chapters in human history that we're writing. What happens is you don't have the incentives to do the right thing in foreign countries, and you have places like Fox Broadcasting say, well, most of the problem is being caused abroad, so let's do nothing. And it becomes a kind of a race to the bottom. And, you know, it's certainly one where I sign up to be a teammate, but I don't want to overpromise and underdeliver as to what a McCord administration will do. Well, first of all, that it generates long-term resources. The use of natural gas generates long-term resources substantially to improve the quality of environmental protection and the use of innovative technologies that protect people who protect the environment and protect people who live near the places where natural gas is being drilled and fracked. Second, where you're generating resources to invest in something that is of steep value to all Pennsylvanians so that we stop ripping off the people of Pennsylvania and instead reward them and include what a business person would call an escrow account for unintended consequences, because we've sort of seen this movie before where a natural resource is extracted and whether it's 5,000 miles of streams that run pink or flooding after deforestation and so forth. We probably don't know all of the consequences. We might say it's safer than coal, it's worth doing on balance. That's different from saying we have perfect 2020 vision for everything, so we need an escrow account. The other thing I would say is I hope that we can embrace a sort of fundamental shift in the way we think about consumption. Instead of thinking, as my generation was raised to, I just want the biggest, fastest cars, I want the biggest houses, I want McMansions, I want to live in the exurbs, instead celebrate much more work, live, play environments, less reliance on consumption in a way that creates carbon emissions, more celebration of lifestyles that are more considerate of future generations. To the extent that we can celebrate green economic development, I think we're culturally, as well as economically, doing the right thing for Pennsylvania.